The Glyptodon is an extinct mammal, distantly related to modern armadillos. It lived during the Pliocene and Pleistocene epochs, which took place 5.3 million to just under 12,000 years ago. That's quite a long time to be on planet Earth, and they didn't go extinct that long ago. They disappeared right around the time of the Ice Age. But the change in climate on planet Earth wasn't the only reason why glyptodons are no longer with us. Glyptodon lived at the same time as early humans, and definitely interacted with them. It is believed that the glyptodon went extinct because they were hunted by humans. But what if the glyptodon didn't go extinct and managed to live on until modern day? How would it have changed the ecosystems, environment, and human civilization? That's what we are going to talk about right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobray. This is where I remind you to smash the thumbs up, subscribe, and notification bell. And don't forget to stick around to the end of the video where we will be responding to users' comments. Darwin is known for finding the first glyptodon fossils, but they were first mentioned in Europe in 1823 in Cuvier's Ossemens Fossils. Like its armadillo cousins, the glyptodon was encased in a hard, thick protective armor. They were pretty large and could grow to be up to 3 meters or 11 feet long, 4.9 feet high, and weighed up to a ton, which is about as much as a car. And it sort of had the build of a car too, a Volkswagen Beetle specifically. Glyptodons also had an armored tail with spikes on it that it may have used to club predators or other glyptodons. But glyptodons weren't predators. They were herbivores and ate mostly plants and insects. They also had stubby, turtle-like legs, which meant that they couldn't travel very fast. But the glyptodon didn't really need to be able to get around quickly to get away from predators. It had virtually no predators because its armor was virtually impenetrable, and its strong tail was strong enough that it could have shattered the backs of other glyptodons. But if you happened to flip a glyptodon onto its back, it would have a lot of trouble getting up, and its soft underbelly would have been exposed, making it vulnerable. So maybe there were predators that figured that out. Mainly humans. Humans were likely the main cause for the glyptodon's extinction. It was likely hunted for its meat as well as its shell. There is evidence to suggest that South American settlers used the glyptodon's shell as a shelter. Pun very much intended. Fossils for the glyptodon have been found all over North and South America, from southern Brazil to Uruguay to Argentina. The glyptodon had a large habitat. So if the glyptodon hadn't gone extinct, they would have continued to be hunted by both early and modern humans. Glyptodons would have had to have been quite numerous to not go extinct if they were being constantly hunted by humans. Glyptodon meat as well as glyptodon byproducts would be readily available. It's very possible that their shells, if they were big enough, could have been used as a small but durable house. They were only 4.5 feet tall, but if they hadn't gone extinct, it's likely we would have seen evidence of entire Aboriginal communities where the huts were glyptodon shells. Imagine it. Rows upon rows, towns, and even cities made up entirely of glyptodon shells. If you managed to get past a mama glyptodon, which would have been pretty difficult, the shells of young glyptodons would have been used for bowls and pottery. We would have seen evidence of many different South American cultures having an obsession with them. Glyptodon jewelry, artwork, rituals, and songs. Modern environmentalists and animal rights activists would not have allowed the glyptodon to go extinct. They would have been protected. There would be wildlife reserves where the glyptodon could roam free, and maybe even safaris that would allow tourists to observe them. In terms of the environment and ecosystems, it's likely that the glyptodon wouldn't have changed much. It was a herbivore, after all, and in South America, particularly the Amazon, there are plenty of plants to go around. Sadly, like many other animals, humans hunted the glyptodon to the point of extinction. Without our reckless disregard for the well-being of Earth's creatures, giants like the glyptodon would still exist today. What do you think would happen if the glyptodon didn't go extinct? Let us know in those comments. I'm going to wrap up this video with some comment replies. Haven DeBaller said, "Do a video that's titled, What if the asteroid that hit the dinosaurs missed?" That's actually a great idea for a video. Thanks, Haven. Pablo Escobar said, "What if Iceland and Greenland went to war?" That is a good question, but probably not much would happen, honestly. Blank Bank said, "What if George Washington was still alive?" I'm definitely down to answer that question. For now though, you should check out our video, What If George Washington Was Assassinated? Clickable on your screen right now. Commando said, "If anyone actually sees, I just wanted to let you know that I hope you do really well in life and follow your dreams. My dreams are to do well on YouTube." Thanks, Commando, I hope all your dreams come true too. Dillman101 said, "I love Lucky Charms. Like if you agree." I definitely liked because I definitely agree. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobray and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, you will love our playlist, Biggest What Ifs, clickable on the screen right now. And make sure you subscribe to notifications by clicking the bell. And we will see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.